Oh, hey, how are you doing? I'm Sue Ellen Garner. Some people call me Go-Go. And I'm here to talk to you today from Vacation Bible School at First Baptist Church. And today we're going to talk about our theme, which is construction and cranes. And we're going to talk about building. And building is so exciting. I'm so glad to get to talk to you today. We're going to talk about tall buildings. And tall buildings are amazing, but they start with at the bottom. They start with a firm foundation. That means when you start to build a building, you have to start with a strong, unbreakable bottom, something that will support you no matter what. We're not going to fall off. It's not going to crack. It's going to be a strong foundation, because a foundation is the bottom, the support that holds you up all the time. You know, we have plans when we build buildings. That's what all this paper is. This is my plan to build my building. But we, as Christians, have plans for our lives, plans to grow and to become strong and godly boys and girls. And our plan is the Bible. This is the Word of God, and this is what we learn about at Vacation Bible School, and that's what we're going to talk about today, a story from the Word of God. And it's so important that you listen, because I want you to understand that you can have a firm foundation, you can have strong support in your life if you study God's Word. And today we're going to talk about Jesus and his special friend named Matthew. You know, this was a long time ago, but we still have good friends. Jesus did not just hang out by himself. He got a bunch of friends around him to hang out with him and to learn about God. And that's what we do here at church. We want to gather our friends together and learn about God. Well, Matthew was a special man. He did not know Jesus, but Jesus was looking for Matthew. Matthew had a special job. Matthew worked for the government, and he collected money from people so that they could build roads and buildings and everything, so everyone, and parks for everyone to enjoy. But he was called a tax collector. Tax collector collects money for the government. And the thing about tax collectors back in Jesus' time is that they weren't always fair. Sometimes they took more money than they should from people. They did not always act fairly and honest. And a lot of people did not like tax collectors. I'm sure you have some friends that maybe aren't always fair. Like maybe when they're handing out cookies, they take more than they're supposed to. Or maybe when you're supposed to be in line and take turns, they jump in line, or they don't behave properly all the time at school. And it's hard to kind of like those people. And back in Jesus' day, it was hard for people to like people like Matthew that were tax collectors, because they didn't always play fair. So it was kind of hard. But guess what? Jesus loved Matthew. Jesus loves everyone. And Jesus chose Matthew. One day Matthew was working and he was collecting money for the government, and Jesus saw him and he walked up to him and he said, "Hey Matthew, will you be my friend? Will you hang out with me? Will you follow me?" And you know what Matthew said? "Sure." So he started hanging out with Jesus, going places with Jesus, studying about God with Jesus. And like a lot of our friends, we want them to hang around us all the time. And that's the way Matthew felt about Jesus. And so he said, "Hey, Jesus, why don't you come to my house and have dinner?" And Jesus said, "Sure." So Matthew invited all of his friends. Now, you can imagine some of Matthew's friends were tax collectors. They were people that weren't always honest and fair. And they all came to dinner, and Jesus came to dinner, and they were having a great time. But guess what happened? Some of Jesus' friends did not understand what Jesus was doing. And they said, "Why is Jesus hanging out with these people that aren't nice?" And Jesus had to explain, "I have come for all people, good people, bad people." You know, before we even know who Jesus is, Jesus loves us and wants us to come to him. And there's a song I like that talks about, that says, "Jesus loves me when I'm good, when I do the things I should. Jesus loves me when I'm bad, even though it makes him sad." And that's the truth. Jesus loves you, and that's what our Bible tells us. And that's what we're here to study about when we come to Vacation Bible School. So Jesus chose Matthew. Jesus loved Matthew, and Matthew became one of his disciples that that went around and told other people about Jesus, and that's so important. And he even wrote a book of the Bible, which is even more amazing. So we love Matthew and we love Jesus, and I want you to understand who Jesus is to you, because Jesus has chosen you as well, and he loves you. You know, God created us. He made Adam and Eve a long, long time ago, but he made you too. And he sent you to your family, and he sent you to Fernandina, and he's brought you to Vacation Bible School, even on this video. And he wants you to know how much he loves you. And he created you and wants you to grow and wants you to build your lives into godly lives. But guess what? We have a problem. We all do things wrong sometimes. We make mistakes. We hurt people's feelings. We aren't always fair. We're kind of like Matthew sometimes. But guess what? God planned a way for us to live with him forever. God's perfect. And if we do things wrong, we can't live with him. He can't tolerate bad things. He can't tolerate what we call sin. And so what he did was he made a plan. And he sent Jesus to the earth to live and to teach people about God and to love them and show them how much God loves them. And so when Jesus came, he loved people like Matthew. He showed us all about God. And then a bad thing happened. He was killed on the cross. And when he was killed on the cross, he said, God, forgive them. They don't really know what they're doing to me. And he died, and they put him in a tomb. And guess what? After 3 days, he rose from the dead, proving he was God. And so if you believe that and you realize that you do things wrong and you're a sinner like Matthew, that you make mistakes and you do unfair things and you do things that will keep you from God, God says that if you believe in Jesus and that he died for you and rose from the dead, that you can be saved and live with God forever. And that problem of sin is gone, and you can live forever with God. And if we believe in our heart, Jesus will save us. And we are so happy to share that good news with you at Vacation Bible School. I want you to talk to your parents or talk to a leader about that if you feel that you believe that. It's so important that you do that this week. Now, I want you to understand that that love that Jesus had is our foundation. That means we can live our whole lives built on that truth. So now I would like for you to do a little activity with me. It's going to be so fun, and it will help you understand just how important a firm foundation, a strong basis for your building is. And remember, we're building lives. We want to grow and be godly boys and girls. So I want you to go to your pantry, ask mom first or dad, and go to your pantry and find the biggest, heaviest can you can find. And we're going to put them back. Don't forget that. We're going to find the biggest can we can find. This is a can of tomatoes. It's really heavy and it's strong and it can take a lot of pressure. And that's what I want you to think about. This represents God's love. When you see this big heavy can, you think about how much God loves you, because that is going to help you with the rest of your life. If you can remember every morning when you wake up, Jesus loves me, God loves me, and he approves of me, then you can build the rest of your life on that promise and on that truth. So this is the love of God and Jesus. And then we're going to have relationships with our family. We're going to be kind to our brothers and sisters. We're going to love each other. We're going to forgive. We're going to have good friends. We're going to be honest and kind and fair to our friends. We're going to study hard at school and work hard and do what our teacher asks us. We're going to read our Bible because that's what tells us about God and about Jesus' love. So all these things we can build, and we can become really, really good followers of Jesus. So when you take all these cans and little things from your pantry and you build this strong tower, I want you to think about being a strong, godly young boy or girl for Jesus, and go out and tell your friends like Matthew did, and invite them to be friends with Jesus too. And that's when you invite them to watch Vacation Bible School or to come to church And that's the best thing you can do for your friends. If you love your friends, you'll lead them to Jesus. And I want you to remember that. I have something else that's really exciting I want to show you. And this is your Vacation Bible School activity book. And this is very important. You need to look at this and show it to your parents. Every day you can look in here and there'll be a devotion that will tell you how to grow and be closer to Jesus. And it's specifically for you every single day. There will also be activities in here and craft ideas that are really going to make things more real to you as you study about God and His Word. After this video, I want you to tell your parents to help you to go to the next video, which is a craft video that I think you'll find to be a lot of fun. So I hope you enjoy that. And I just want you to know that I have thoroughly enjoyed talking to you today, and I hope you will come back and really look at all the things that Vacation Bible School has to offer and really dive into it with your whole heart. Jesus loves you. See you soon.